Thanks, Ciara, leader. Could I just take this opportunity to reflect on the last 4 days of polls and elections, and in my own case especially, across the Republic of Ireland, Northern Ireland and the UK, and with my fellow senators, take the opportunity to congratulate all those who were successful and actually commiserate with all those candidates who were unsuccessful in either council or European elections. We're in changing times, and we're witnessing a seismic shift in the more recognised voting patterns from an intelligent electorate who have sent clear messages to all our parties. They don't want ambiguity or mixed messages. They don't want negativity and gloom, and they don't want entrenched positions based on history and rhetoric. What they do want is a clear manifesto and clearly defined objectives. They want positivity and they want solutions to problems. They want people prepared to take on local, national and international challenges by working with others for the greater good. But most of all, leader, in my opinion, they want change. More than ever, it was highlighted yesterday north of the border, where Naomi Long was elected as the first MEP who didn't define herself as a unionist or a nationalist. In a province where we have focused for decades on voting to keep people out of office based on party politics, rather than voting to put people in, the tide may be turning. At the count yesterday, where Diane Dodds of the DUP was returned first, Martina Anderson of Sinn Féin had the most first preferences, and Naomi Long of Alliance captured more votes than any other candidate, actually took the second seat of three. Congratulations to all, and actually, it must be noted, they're all women. It was truly a historic day, and it was clear evidence that the electorate want political representation for all, irrespective of cultural identity, and not defined by historic identities. In fact, I listened with some concern as unionist voters supporting Alliance were described last night by one political leader as unionists with a small u, implying there are different ranks of unionism. I would tend to disagree and would take offence to this comment. Unionism is unionism, nationalism is nationalism, just as loyalism is loyalism and republicanism is republicanism. In 1959, Johnny Cash sang about 40 shades of green, and I would suggest there have always been 40 shades of green. I would argue, actually, there's 40 shades of orange, all with unique perspectives and points of difference. However, unionism, nationalism, loyalism and republicanism has changed. It's not the same as it was 10, 20, 50 or 100 years ago, and it shouldn't be defined as such, and it will change further. Politics needs to acknowledge and reflect this and not to refer to old stereotypes and labels. If we need to take anything from the weekend, it's that the people in Ireland and the UK are ahead of the politicians. The new generation of voters will place higher demands on politicians and leaders to deliver on promises. Leader, as we conclude this round of elections, everyone has a responsibility to reflect on gains and losses, on successes and failures, and strive to work across both houses of the Oireachtas to deliver security, peace and prosperity for all the people in Ireland, irrespective of their political affiliation or identity. People, parties and politics will change, but the business of government will go on, and the important discussions for citizens around health, housing, education, agriculture, transport, climate will all endure.